related to the different formats of work. Different formats of work, and we start from gigabit and improvements which can be made for every G file and G file support of monkeys.
Hello everyone, my name is Roman Sedorovsky, I'm with Kubernetes. The purpose of my presentation today is present you our Kubernetes product enhancement for the previous year and show how our latest improvements can be used for export custom geometry in AFA-LG files. So, main areas of my presentation and product is first of all is file format, region and region interface for any elements inside file formats. The second one big part is rendering and our rendering improvements. Next is our changes for element creation. We are continuing to develop this library. This is a huge task for us, and we continue to work with this. And in the future, I will show you how we can export custom geometry country. So let's start with file format. For the latest release, we added support latest file formats 2018. This is currently it's our base file format for Tigabin and any other file formats not converted to the latest work. Latest file format contains about 4,000 of classes, and we update our elements and elements interface with new format. And for latest release, we also added conversion for 2016 and 2017 file formats. So this, the data will be converted to the latest, and we can work with them like the newest file format. But we continue working for another formats, and they are also available, but not all of them converted to the new version. For our elements, we have our TF interface. It can be used for general works, but we create now written interface. And in this moment, we create written interface for of classes which available in our file formats. So next area is our rendering improvements. It's also very important for customers. For rendering improvements, is the biggest changes was done for visual style support on our in our product. We have visual style support in our rendering framework. Of course, TigaBeam project use our rendering framework and use visual styles rendering, but our visual styles has some features depending on the format. So next is fill patterns. Currently we can render it and use it for objects. The fill patterns also dependent on visual styles, and they dependent on materials, is a part of material. And they also is a part of materials changes. So we also implement region split faces for rendering, and we create possibility to render annotation element on the first one of the on the screen. So first of all, visual styles. Inside Vim, we have restrictions from the point file formats. In our formats, visual styles is a part of DB view. So currently we support it, we can use it, but customers cannot create their own visual style, edit in database and use it. You have to use visual styles provided by file format, but any changes any settings which are in the BU and working for visual styles like different jitters, transparency, enable ages, disable are available. So on the screen you can see the examples of four visual styles. First of all is wireframe mode. On this screen also enable sketch mode for rendering of visual styles. Second one is hit and line. On the bottom screen you can see shaded mode and realistic mode. Quite different colors, but I will describe it a bit later. So next one is fill patterns. So for fill patterns support for BIM, we have to change our rendered framework also. We extend the functionality for support this in BIM, but this functionality currently available for another project which is using our rendering framework. So our fill patterns usually are used on filled regions, and this is an analog of H inside drawings. And also our fill patterns might be used on faces of BDFs. This is a part of material, and they will be used on sexual and kind of cutting geometry. So currently we can draw in solid patterns and different hatches patterns. So several examples you can see on the screen. Next one is material, fill patterns, visual styles. Indirectly depend on materials because different visual styles using different parts of materials. So on the screen you can see a box which are drawn in two different visual styles. Blue box is shaded mode. So for shaded mode you one asset from material. Also it will draw a few patterns on the face as if it's set. But in the realistic mode, we start using another set. It can have another color in the material. It can have a texture, you can see on the right box. And if the texture available, it will be drawn. And fill pattern automatically it is able for realistic render mode. So we change as it changes for material support. It's also required our improvements of our standard, our rendering framework, because from in products it's additional needs that was implemented. I want to show several slides, materials and visual styles on a building model. So on the screen you can see hidden line visual style. Here also enabled the sketches for ages. You can see few patterns on roof, floor, walls, and for hidden line water and often white color automatically used for any objects. So next one is shaded mode. Currently you can see also few patterns on the same places, so roofs, walls, and false, but in this mode, colors also shaded mode, the consistent color modes are enabled, and they are using, you can see on the roof, on the windows. And next one is realistic. Currently, fill patterns disabled. Several elements start using another colors because the materials. These colors and materials which have texture are using them. So let's continue with our another entities, elements which we currently start rendering. faces inside the blade of beam can have additional regions on them, and this region can use additional, not additional, their own materials. On this clear, you can see an extrusion on the top face of this extrusion, also that several additional regions, and these regions using different material from parent object. And currently, we start rendering these elements, and you can see on the screen. This functionality usually appears like design parts for different objects. For example, on the cap of the truck, white line is split, for instance. So currently, we also render it correctly. So next one is the annotation element for BIM projects. Our annotation element must be always on the top of another geometry. This is was a problem previously because we drew this another model. Currently we divide our entities on annotation entities and all another entities for any division. And for support draw an annotation entity on the top of any elements, we edit one more JS view, and inside we draw annotation view on one, annotation elements on one view, and another elements on another view. And annotation elements always will be drawn on the top of another geometry. Annotation elements is usually text, dimensions, and text, and so on. So you can see on the screen an example test text on the 3D wall and one section. So next big area for us is writing support. For writing support, our new file format is also very important. Introduce a new file format for our products is meaning we start saving our files in the latest file format. We save files only in the latest file format, and when we introduce new format, we change version for saving files. So currently 28 in our base file format, and any four files which we save will be saved to the latest. So for this area, conversion of formats also important because if we open file and convert the data, then we can save them. Currently, we can save for the files 2016 and 2017 to the latest file format. For another format, this functionality is in development, and currently, such files cannot be saved. So next steps on elements creation. This is huge task, and for this we create some big steps for previous year. So first of all, we start generation header of elements. In the BIM format, any elements have headers which contain and base information for any element. This is the static information. This is the same number of properties for any element, but it must be saved filled correctly. It contains like such properties like family ID, category ID, bounding box, and so on. So for generation header, also was important creation calculate expense of element, because header has this information inside, and this information must be calculated and set in the header correctly. So we implement calculation extension for elements, and currently this functionality is working for generation. So the next part is label deals. We are using this model for output different units to four dimensions, for example. So file formats inside docs with internal measurements of units. It's usually inches, feet, and so on. But for output on the screen in internal units must be converted by the project settings. We are using for this conversion variable tools model we provided with sources for any customers, so you can change it, extend it, and modify if our implementation by some reason doesn't work for you. So it's conversion for measurements, but also variable tools has customers description for different parameters, different groups, categories, and so on. So we can get by parameters description from variable tools, but we have only English description inside. But if you need another languages, you can extend this model and use it. So next big area is Brave Builder. This is Brave Builder is not model. This is a helper for creation correct behavior information for behavior data for the file format. So we move general part of the behavior in kernel format. It's work with our geometry primitives, geometry surfaces, geometry curves, and so on. It collect primitive from the customer, so customers must create surfaces, must set characters and set curves, create loops, and so on. Brave Builder should verify this information. And when the customer finish, it call finish method. Finish method must be implemented on the product side. This functionality convert Tigger primitives, geometry primitives, to the file format primitives. So on the for the build, we have implementation this method. So after when the finish it, customer calls the method, and we convert geometry to the PREP, which are using inside PIM file format. So after this, this geometry can be set in an element and use it. So for the previous year, we also added a set of possibility to create a set of elements. First of all is direct shape and freeform elements. These elements which keep custom geometry. So for example, you can create a direct by Brave Builder and get it and set in geometry area for the of these elements and it will be using. So next important element is curve element. It's our step on the generation elements. So for curve element, only one element in BIM database which keep 2D geometry. It can contain line, arc, ellipse, hermit plan, and so on. But for implementation, this element was important also possibility generation. Geometry by data inside the element. So we implement the functionality and currently we can use it. So next one is different views. They all based on DB view and we have it from and currently it is possible to create a 3D view, some plane view, and so on. So next one is the parameters, and currently we have possibility to create custom parameters. So you can create parameter in this description and add instances of these parameters. So they can be added for family, projects, or elements. So, and next big is connections they are using for such elements like different wires, carbon trays, electricity, And so this is logical element, but currently we also provide possibility to create it and store it inside the file. Next is import and export. For Vim, we currently have export for Lada and initial version of the data. This is experts are working on the kernel side. This is base for all products. By any products must implement their own protocol extension for support of this kernel functionality for interaction with the project specific. So this part was implemented for Vim and it's currently working. Import is another case. Import cannot work in general way, and for import must be implemented product specific functionality. So for the previous year we had import Collada, and for import Collada, during the import Collada, we create a set of direct chain parameters and set geometry from the Collada, which we get from the Collada, convert to our command, and set it in direct chain parameters. For Collada import, we provide possibility to select type of geometry which will be stored inside the file. It can be direct data or polymer data. So, and on the examples of import and export Collada, I want to show you our possibility to export Collada, not Collada, custom geometry. Collada here is like a container between two different products. We move geometry from GVG, for example, in Collada file, and after this we can create from this generalized elements and create geometry for Vim and store it inside Vim. So you also can convert your own geometry to our representation and set this example inside game shape elements, for example. I will show it during my demo presentation. So let's continue with demo presentation. On the start, I want to show our random things function, which was shown on the slide, and currently I will show it on real application. This is typically back application. First of all, is few patterns. Here you can see a couple of objects with two different patterns. So, also here you can see visual style support. In Vim we have a predefined set of visual styles. By this reason they added possibility to easily change it in the toolbar, and we can easily change another style, so wireframe mode drawing on the edges, hidden line also show two patterns, and another style, consistent color and realistic. Two patterns drawing can disable, color set another one, and this object doesn't have any textures. So the next one is split face. This is object I shown before. On the wireframe mode, you can see several regions on the top face. And these materials are working different in different visual styles. This is shaded mode, consistent color, and realistic mode. So they're using another one color. So, and the next one is on building example. So, it's opened by default in 3D mode and using realistic mode for rendering. and we can also change when we want here. There is also a possibility to change render mode by a dialogue, and it provides possibility to change some additional settings of Visual Style. For example, we can change transparency and white to the objects. So you can see result. We also can disable edges here. And in this case, all fill patterns and edges disappear because fill patterns is also edges for rendering device. So the next one is hidden line. Hidden line are using edges because in another case, objects completely disappeared from the screen. And here we can enable extension, for example, and jitters. And we get some sketch mode. So let's continue with the example of expert geometry. We will use for this one DG file with architectural objects. So on the open you can see dialog, which the file was saved in previous version, and then architectural objects will be converted to the latest. So it contains a new tag inside. Currently, we will export it by Calada. So the file was created, and currently we start an TK debug application for BIM. For working with BIM, we don't have possibility to create a clear file, so for this reason we will use a template of the open template in the application and call Calada import. So here we should choose our files. And later we can select which type of geometry we want to store inside the elements. So let's start with polygons, for example. And the elements was loaded, and currently we can load it. So the geometry was connected correctly. And I also try to import the model with direct gender. So currently we also use our template, call the import also file. And direct is the default for our import. But now we can slow longer than poly mesh, of course, because creating mirror is more expensive procedure than creation poly mesh. So after this, we run the file and some extents. So it's created. You can see the same building. Change the shader and for example disable show edges for we have some synthetic for the demonstration. So we will save the file and try to open it in Revit, because if we import something inside file and save it in Revit file, it should be opened. is there also find its later inside. So, for example, you can select the variable, and here you can find a set of direct shape elements. So, you also can select any of them and look in on the geometry. So, inside a set of nodes, here on the one node. Geometry and it contains BM geometry. BM geometry is the base for BM geometry in the BM. So our file will look like we will try to open it in Rift. This is where it is performance, so we will open it in the
We can create an empty
file specific families in...
No, even for Revit you can create specific file for families. For families always should be user template because there is a lot of different sort of families. They contain inside a bit different information for families. And families should be always started from the template. But we have plans in the future and possibility to create everything project files from create files. Not from the plate, but by code. But families always should start from the template.
Thank you.